Everyone, I am Ashish Sharma. I am a PhD student in computer science at the University of Washington, and I will present our work on facilitating empathic conversations and online mental health support. This work was done with our clinical psychological operators from Stanford and University of Washington, and a minor in Dave Atkins, with my advisor Tim Meltoff and Ina Lin, who did this work with us over the summer. A content warning before we start. The slides may contain examples related to mental illness and self-harm. But we are only using those examples to illustrate our points better, and we have made sure that all the examples are properly anonymized. All right, so let's get started. Mental illness is a global health issue, but still mental health care remains a global challenge. Most countries have less than one psychiatrist per 100K individuals, and across the globe, we face widespread shortages of workforce for mental health support with limited in-treatment options. So facing this huge gap between need and access, more and more people are instead turning to online peer support platforms such as TalkLife, 7Cups, and mental health subreddits. These platforms enable millions of users to seek and provide support through conversations. In these conversations, a user who wants to seek support, whom we call seeker, posts about his or her mental health related issue and gets responses from peer supporters. A key component for providing effective and successful mental health support is empathy, which is the ability to understand or feel the emotions and experiences of others. So consider an example where the seeker posted, "My whole family hates me." Now, one way of responding empathically to this post would be to understand that if the family of the seeker hates them, it could make them feel isolated. So an empathic peer supporter would say, "If that happened to me, I would feel really isolated." Now, this has a very strong effect in mental health. In fact, studies have shown that empathic interactions have strong associations with symptom improvement in mental health. And even on online peer support platforms, high empathy interactions are received positively by users. However, recent work has shown that highly empathic conversations are rare on peer support platforms. So on these platforms, suggesting actions like try talking to your friends is much more common, but it is not an effective way of providing support. So the key question is, how can we improve empathy in peer-to-peer support? And how can we turn these low empathy conversations on the left into higher empathy conversations on the right? And towards this goal, in this paper, we introduce a new computational task called empathic rewriting, where the aim is to computationally transform low empathy conversations to higher empathy. For example, given a post from a support seeker, "I can't deal with this part of my bipolar, I need help," and a corresponding low empathy response, "Don't worry, try to relax, anyone you can talk to," we want to increase empathy in the response by transforming it to something like, "Being manic is no fun, it's scary. I'm sorry to hear this is troubling you. Try to relax, anyone you can talk to." Now, note that the rewritten response communicates more empathy, and that typically happens either through understanding of feelings and experiences. So understanding that if the seeker is facing bipolar issues, they can have manic faces and it can be scary. And also the display of felt emotions. So saying things like, "I'm so sorry to hear this is troubling you." But empathic rewriting is a really challenging task due to several reasons. First, empathy is a complex phenomenon. It is conceptually nuanced and multidimensional. So people often use empathy and sympathy interchangeably, but empathy is much more than sympathy or even just reacting with positive sentiment. Moreover, the clinically relevant perspective of empathy requires understanding the hidden feelings and experiences of the other person. There is also this recent theoretically grounded framework of empathy proposed with three empathy communication mechanisms: emotional reactions, interpretations, and explorations. So grounding methods in these kind of perspectives of empathy is both critical and challenging. Next, let's try to see why existing approaches may not work for empathic rewriting. So one could take a naive approach of transforming every response to a generic response, like "this must have been really hard for you." But this may seem to quote unquote solve empathic rewriting. It suffers from two key issues. First, it may not be specific to the emotions and experiences expressed by the seeker. And second, performing the same transformation to millions of responses on the platform would dramatically reduce response diversity on the platform. So as in every response on the platform would become, "this must have been really hard for you." Also, empathic rewriting shares surface level similarities with tasks like style transfer or sentiment transfer, but it is significantly different. So often in tasks like style transfer, making the simple word level changes suffices. So example in this text, "the movie was bad." If you just change bad to good, the sentiment will change from negative to positive. But empathic rewriting would typically require multiple new sentences to be added or replaced. Like in the previous example, we needed to add three new sentences. So therefore, existing style transfer approaches may not work, and we will need to build new methods. Also, no parallel dataset exists for empathic rewriting, and creating one is expensive. And for a complex phenomena like empathy, we will likely need domain experts for creating such a dataset, which is really, really challenging. So in this work, we design a reinforcement learning model which addresses these challenges. So our RL model uses a transformer language model for making sentence level edits. It leverages a theoretically grounded empathy framework. It exploits carefully constructed reward functions for ensuring language properties and conversational properties like fluency, specificity, and diversity. And using this reinforcement learning setup, we get rid of the need of ground-truth data set of rewritings. Some of our insights. So we show that we can increase empathy in conversations while maintaining these language and conversation properties. And our gains are over 35% more than baseline methods like BART and DialogGPT, which are state-of-the-art models for similar text generation tasks. So our main dataset comes from DocLife. Overall, it has over 11 million seeker posts, 27 million response posts from 600K users. We find that DocLife hosts a large number of social media interactions. So posts like Happy Mother's Day and these type of posts may not be relevant for our context. So we curate only mental health related conversations using a BERT-based classifier. Next, we computationally label this curated dataset with empathy measurements. And for this, we used a classifier developed in prior work. And we'll use this dataset for a supervised warm start of our RL model later. Our main contribution towards solving empathic rewriting is Partner, which is a reinforcement learning agent for the task of empathic rewriting. So here we use the standard RL setting with states, actions, policies, and rewards. So in our setting, Partner works on a conversation between a seeker and a peer supporter. So it will first extract a state from the conversation, and based on the state, it will perform a set of rewriting actions. And finally, it will get some rewards for training. So in the next set of slides, I will describe the different components of our RL agent. So we use seeker post and fixed length contiguous spans of response post as our states. Our model takes sentence level edits as actions. So it will either insert empathic sentences at various positions, or it will replace existing low empathy sentences with sentences that are more empathic. To be more concrete, at each step, it will take two actions. The first action is selecting a position in the response span for insertion or replacement. And the second action is generating candidate empathic sentences to be used at those positions. So in the example that you see on this slide, through action one, the agent can select the first sentence for replacement. And through action two, it can generate a candidate sentence like being manic is no fun, which can be used for replacing the first sentence. So this slide illustrates our policy network, which uses a transformer language model based on GPT-2. But this policy network takes a seeker post and contiguous chunk of response post as input. It passes them through the transformer language model, which performs the two actions I was talking about, identifying positions to make changes and generating candidate sentences to make those changes. And by applying those actions, you get your final rewritten more empathic response. So our RL model is trained using a series of rewards, which ensure highly empathic rewritings while maintaining fluency, specificity, and diversity. Our first reward is change in empathy, which is computed as empathy of the rewritten response minus empathy of the original response. And we obtain empathy scores based on this theoretically grounded empathy framework and the corresponding classifier developed in prior work, which gives us scores on a scale from 0 to 6. We also have expediency and sentence coherency, which are used to ensure grammatically correct English sentences. And finally, we have mutual information, which we use for ensuring specificity and diversity. So this measure will capture shared information between your seeker post and the generated response, and we'll try to see if you can generate one from the other. Experiments. So we initialize our transformer language model used in our policy network using the pre-trained weights of DialogGPT. Now DialogGPT is GPT-2 pre-trained on Reddit conversations. Next, we do a warm start supervised training. And for this, we use the computationally labeled empathy dataset that we developed earlier. And finally, for evaluation, we combine automatic evaluation with expert-based human evaluation. And we do this because evaluating complex constructs such as empathy is fundamentally challenging. And automatic metrics on these constructs can often be noisy. And therefore, you really need humans to validate your performance. So we performed our automatic evaluation over six automatic metrics, namely change in empathy, perplexity, sentence coherency, specificity, diversity, and edit rate. We compared this model against various dialogue generation and seek-to-seek generation baselines. So this table only shows our results on change in empathy metric. So we find that partner is able to increase empathy on an average by over 1.6 points on the 6-point scale that we had. Now, posts in our dataset have an average empathy score of around 1, and therefore, with partner, those posts can be made over 150% more empathic. Also, this gain is more than 35% than all of our baseline methods, which are state-of-the-art for similar tasks. So, to conclude, we find that partner outperforms baselines in empathy improvement, and it's simultaneously able to generate fluent, specific, and diverse outputs. And in fact, it is able to achieve that with lower number of edits. Now, automatic metrics on these tasks can be often very noisy. Therefore, we also perform human evaluation. And for this, we recruit six graduate students in clinical psychology. Now, most of these participants were PhD students in second or subsequent years of their degree program. And according to our clinical psychology collaborators, they had significant expertise in empathy and mental health support. For our human evaluation, we do A-B testing. So we show our participants an output from a model and a corresponding output from a baseline. And we ask them to choose the output which is more empathic, fluent, and specific. So this plot shows our human evaluation results for empathy and specificity. So on the y-axis, you see different baselines. And on the x-axis, you see preference scores. So values greater than 50% here indicate preference towards our model. And we find that human experts prefer partner over baselines, both in terms of empathy and specificity. Next, we analyze adaptability of different models. So on online peer support platforms, you will find all sorts of responses. So some responses may need a lot more help with empathy, while others may not need any help at all. And through our analysis, we find that partner adapts well to these different kinds of responses. So it is able to improve non-empathic responses by more than 2 empathy points, and it's the only model which does not make an already empathic response worse. So here I want to show you an example demonstrating our system. So to a seeker post, I feel like nobody cares about my existence, and an original response, I feel the same. So a model like dialogivity can only rewrite it to I care, which honestly is not that great, whereas partner, which is a model, can rewrite it to, it's hard to find others who can relate, I feel the same. So the model is inferring seeker's perspective from their post, which makes the final output more empathic and potentially more helpful. There are more such examples in the paper, do check that out. So to summarize, empathic conversations are crucial for effective online mental health support, but empathy is rarely expressed online. So the question is, how can we facilitate empathic conversations? And towards this goal, in this paper, we proposed this new task called empathic rewriting for computationally transforming low empathy conversations to higher empathy. We proposed a partner, which is a reinforcement learning agent for empathic rewriting. And we show that partner can effectively increase empathy in conversations while maintaining language and conversational properties like fluency, specificity, and diversity. And we demonstrate that through both human and automatic evaluation. So this task can be used for giving intelligent, actionable feedback to users with concrete, context-specific, and diverse suggestions on these online peer support platforms. And this forms an interesting future work. Our codes and models are available online. Thanks a lot for listening, and I will see you at the conference.